Antonio Bob, meron ba tayong legal recourse? And this is my last question, Mr. Chairman. Alam natin na this came from stolen money. May hacking or kung ano man nangyari, hindi yan pera ng limang tao na pinasok yung pera, hindi yung pera ni William Go, hindi rin yung pera ni Philem, hindi yung pera ni RCBC that came from Bangladesh. Aside from the cash, natitrace naman natin kung saan napunta yung pera. May legal recourse pa tayo na kuhanin ulit yung pera para maibalik natin sa Bangladesh?
If we can identify, Your Honor, that the money is still there, then we can recover that. However, if the money is no longer there or no longer available...
Oh, it's there. Mr. Wong is saying, nandiyan pa, di ba, sir? Matitrace natin.
But he said that as far as the 550 million pesos is concerned, it has been checked in. I don't know what checked in means.
Anyway, are our laws strong enough to recover that money? Yun yung last question ko. Kaya pa ng mga batas natin na ma-recover yung pera niya or may kakulangan yung batas natin, hindi na natin ma-recover kung nakapasok na sa mga kasino, nakapasok na sa ibang transaction, hindi na ma-recover o ma-recover? Kaya pa ang hindi?
Well, there are remedies provided under the law.
And that is one of the remedies, if I understand.
One of the remedies provided under the law is the forfeiture of any assets identified to be related to any unlawful activity or the money laundering offense. So under the AMLA, the AMLAC has a power to institute petition for civil forfeiture against all these properties or assets that have been identified, that are deemed related to unlawful activity.
Thank you, Attorney Abad. And of course, we're doing the hearing so people will know what really happened or people can judge for themselves what talaga yung nangyari. But at the end of the day, yung proseso po ninyo will determine whether may babalik natin a part, whole, konto o karamihan ng pera na nanakaw. And we hope that you can really go through that process properly. And if you need the help of the Senate to change the laws or make things stronger, nandito naman po kami na tutulong sa inyo. Thank you. Thank you, Mr. Chairman.
Thank you, Senator Bang. No, just an administrative before we go to Senator Coco na maganda na dahan ko. Pero Senator Bang, you made a request. I just want to clarify. You want to call to the hearing, correct me if I'm wrong, call to the hearing the junket operators.
The representatives of the junket operator in the Philippines. So they for themselves.
Soler and Maybas?
No, just Soler.
Soler, how many junket
just
operators do you have?
Quick and kindly tell the chairman.
I suppose, Your Honor, you're referring to the junket operators identified in our report. There are two, Your Honor.
So, Senator,
I would like to hear from them where the money went, because I think what's important is we recover the
yes,
money.
Yes. In fact, when this hearing started, I was under the impression that the 1.36 was still frozen. So I said, some of this maybe there's 1.36 billion that we can still return to Bangladesh. But now I find out that it's been converted into chips and has been already
Zachary.
Okay. Mr. Tan, you can produce the two junket operators.
We will, Your Honor.
You will?
Well, we'll ask them to come here, Your Honor, for the next hearing.
No, you tell me now, because if it's needed, we can subpoena them. So you tell me whether you can or you cannot.
Maybe they should be subpoenaed, Your Honor.
You cannot require them.
Well, when we
investigate... They are regular customers of yours?
Yes, sir. They operate inside our casino.
So if you say, if you don't go to the Senate, then we don't do business with you, then I suppose they will come. My point is, don't you have a hold over them?
We have a contract, Your Honor. Part of the contract says they should follow Philippine law, so...
Okay, so... Sige. The concert is here, but would you supply the names and their addresses?
Yes, Your Honor.
To the concert right after this hearing, so we can issue the
yes,
subpoena. Senator Aquino, I've got one in my last note. Ah, no, that's something wrong, no? Okay, that's easier already. Okay. I think that's very, very important for the public to know that the last remedy is a civil case, attorney of that, a civil case, not a criminal case for forfeiture of assets. Am I correct?
Yes, Your Honor, it's a civil forfeiture case, Your Honor.
Civil forfeiture. And, yes, Senator Aquino.
Very quickly, are there efforts to invite Mr. Wei Kang-soo? Who is, anyone, Mr. Wong?
Yes, Mr. Abad, I understand you talked to the immigration authorities on the matter of Mr. Wei Kang-soo. What was the latest, by the immigration?
Based on our query with the Bureau of Immigration, their records would show that from the time Mr. Wei Kang-soo arrived in Manila sometime in 2015, I think April 2015, there's no record of departure. However, we received information that this Mr. Wei Kang-soo probably has left the country via a private plane, Your Honor.
That's still the situation, Mr. Chairman.
I suppose if it's a private plane, you still have to go through immigration. But what did immigration say?
They don't have a record of his departure, Your Honor.
You don't have a record of his departure?
VI, Your Honor.
Yes, Mr. Chairman, Senator Aquino.
Mr. Wei Kang-soo is a known person to Mr. Wong and to Maylas.
Yes, I was getting to that.
His telephone number, his
yes.
address. Na-text niyo po ba si Mr. Wei Kang-soo, Mr. Wong? I mean, nangyayari na to?
Hindi ko pa nakakausap po.
You didn't try to?
Kasi ano, player po siya ikaw. Pero pwede ko pa pa-check po.
Sige.
Kasi nagtatago pa ako eh.
Okay. Can you kindly locate Mr. Wei Kang-soo and the secretary, I'm sure, can subpoena him here also if he's still in the Philippines. Mr. Wong, if you can help us.
Kung wala ako siya dito, mapupunta ko.
Okay, thank you.
The consul is hereby ordered to issue a subpoena for Mr. Wei Kang-soo on the presumption that we have enough information. And, Mr. Bang, it's incumbent upon you. Can we get a confirmation, second confirmation again, from the immigration authorities as to whether they know the whereabouts of Mr. Wei Kang-soo?
We will, Your Honor.
How about Maldas? Can you tell us anything? Are you presenting Maldas?
Yes, Your Honor.
Okay.
We have a prepared statement, Your Honor.
No. This is not, I'm not talking about the statement. I'm talking about Mr. Wei Kang-soo. Do you have?
No, Your Honor, because the presence of Mr. Wei Kang-soo, if he plays in Maylas, is actually pre-cleared by Eastern Hawaii. And once it is pre-cleared, that it is established that he in fact played, they actually forward to the PAGCOR branch manager assigned in Maylas a photocopy of his passport. So as we have mentioned earlier, I believe that PAGCOR will produce the records of Mr. Wei Kang-soo if he had played in Maylas before.
Okay, but I'm not too interested right now. I want a definitive answer. Does anybody know whether Mr. Wei Kang-soo, you're operating the casino, so is Mr. Wei Kang-soo playing in your casinos right now?
Sir, Mr. Chairman, I believe that we actually have signed an agreement of a sub-agency agreement with Eastern Hawaii. And in our case, Eastern Hawaii, who actually operates the...
So in other words, you wouldn't know?
We wouldn't know exactly.
You operate a casino, but you don't know who goes in and out.
We have a record, Your Honor, that has been submitted.
Okay, then let's not dilly-dally on this point. Anyway, Mr. Kim Wong, you said hahanapin mo po.
Opo.
Okay. Now we go to Senator Popo to Winter.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. For PAGCOR, Mr. Manalastas, you've heard the explanation of Attorney Ripomoseno hiding under a sub-agency agreement. Should you continue with such kind of an arrangement? It confuses the situation and people can hide behind the agreements. Will you continue to allow this?
Sir, if I may, we still derive income from such operations. What we cannot provide directly, the junket operators can offer. So in a way, they still help in attracting big players from abroad.
The casino in Midas Hotel is Padcor operated.
Yes, sir.
So you put up that casino to compete with your own flagship project, the Entertainment City. What's the logic? Putting up your own casino to compete with the casinos you have incentivized to locate in Park Entertainment City?
Sir, they have, well, in the casino, we have different types of market. So there has a foreign market, which is the bigger group, and we cater to the locals also.
Locals can pay, so there? Is that right, Attorney Tan?
Yes, Your Honor.
So, I don't see the point. Anyway, you better review the logic behind you having a flagship project called Entertainment City, and then you're supposed to protect that project to make the locators there earn money, and then you want to compete with them by putting up your own casino just a couple of kilometers away. Anyway, for Attorney Nicomoseno, you, in one breath, you mentioned Eastern Hawaii and a certain Oriental earlier. What are those two entities and how are they related?
Your Honor, Oriental Casino is actually the trade name of the junket room in Midas Casino. And Eastern Hawaii is the sub-agent.
Oriental Casino is the trade name of the junket room.
Yes, Your
so
Honor.
So that is the entity with which Padcor has a contract, tama? Because Padcor operates the main casino, tama po ba yan? Is that correct?
Your Honor, Padcor has a contract with Brian Investment Korea Inc., our company, and we actually in turn have a sub-agency agreement with Eastern Hawaii.
Okay, but you own the trademark of Oriental Casino?
It is owned by Eastern Hawaii, Your Honor, I believe.
You don't know?
I believe Your Honor is owned by Eastern Hawaii. I know for a fact that it's being used in Midas Hotel and Casino.
You don't care? You don't care to find out?
Your Honor, it's owned by by Eastern Hawaii.
Okay, to Director Abad, against whom have we filed money laundering cases or complaints as of today?
As of today, Your Honor, we have filed two criminal complaints. The first one is against Ms. Maya De Quito and the four account holders, and the second one is against Mr. Kam Sin Wong, aka Kim Wong, and Mr. Wei Kang Soo, Your Honor.
Seven, at least against seven personalities? Yeah. And what is the basis of your case against Mr. Kim Wong? Is it because of the testimony of Maya De Quito that he was the one who told her to open the four fictitious accounts, or is it because of the transfer of funds from Eastern Hawaii to his personal account?
Yes, sir. It was based on the fact that he received money from Eastern Hawaii, which is, as far as our investigation is concerned, part of the stolen funds from the Bangladesh Bank.
So, you stated in one of our earlier hearings that it's important to that there should be knowledge of the illegal source or the unlawful activity behind the money for this. So that means that UNLAC is convinced that Mr. Kim Wong has knowledge of the illegal source or the unlawful activity which generated the money transfer to his account. So, but if we put the events on a timeline, he's actually on the ending part. So I'm wondering why an actor like Phil Ren, who is if not in the middle, but at the beginning part of the timeline of the timeline of events, constituting money laundering. How come Phil Ren is? How come you do not attribute knowledge to Phil Ren, because you did not even freeze the Phil Ren accounts, and you didn't file a case against Phil Ren?
Well, as I said earlier, Your Honor, the unlocked files criminal complaint as evidence would warrant. And based on our initial investigation, early on, we already found out that all those persons who, against whom we filed criminal complaint, there are circumstances which show that they knew that the money transacted came from stolen funds. However, as far as the funeral is concerned, when we looked at the transactions, initially it would appear that these were regular transactions as a remittance company. We would we saw that there were a lot of transactions coming in and out of Phil Rem's account, and so we would at first we thought that this money that were remitted from the account of quote unquote William Sogo were also part of its daily regular business, Your Honor. But as I've said, we haven't completed our investigation. Our investigation is still ongoing, and we are verifying certain facts, Your Honor.
Yeah, I read the one news report which stated that Phil Ren has 100,000 transactions. I don't know if that's a day or a month, but the average amount involved is $500. So even if they have many transactions, if you look at the average amount, $500, these particular transactions are not maybe part of thousands of transactions, but from the amount, they are not usual. Because the average amount is $500.
This amounts may be unusual, but I think, if I'm not mistaken, in the past there were also relatively large transactions in the account, the company account of Phil Ram, Your Honor.
So why did AMLAC attribute knowledge on the part of Kim Wong, who is at the end of the timeline, because that's the destination account, PNB account, is that right?
Yes, Your Honor.
So why do we attribute knowledge on the part of Kim Wong, and then we do not attribute knowledge on the part of Phil Ren, which played a very crucial role in distributing, in remitting the amounts?
Because based on our investigation, Your Honor, it would appear that Mr. Kim Wong is one of the ultimate beneficiaries of this account. And considering the circumstances that attended the series of transfers involving this fund, it would appear that he knew from the start that the money is coming and that the money came from some unlawful activity, Your Honor. But as in contrast, as far as Phil Ren is concerned, at first it would appear that the money just passed through it as a remittance company. But I'm not saying at this point, Your Honor, that Phil Ren is completely innocent of all these things, Your Honor.
But my point is this: when you applied for a freeze order for the account of Kim Wong, you still have not heard the testimony that he was involved in the early part, according to Maya Bigito, that he was the one who introduced the five account holders to him. So all you knew was that his PNB account was a destination of the money. So that's the ending, and yet you attributed knowledge on his part. And then here comes one critical player in the narration, and you do not attribute knowledge. So I'm just wondering, why the different treatment? I hope you get my point. Okay, but that was before. But now that you have heard additional testimony, and according to Mr. Kim Wong, there is an unaccounted $17 million, which he alleges are still with Phil Ren. So, don't you have any power or any weapon under your disposal to at least believe the allegation of Mr. Kim Wong and trying to save the $17 million by freezing it or applying for a freeze order?
The problem, Your Honor, is I think this missing $17 million have been withdrawn in cash. And probably it's, I don't know.
Yeah, but did you even try?
We just tried based
on... No, did you even try to now that you have heard this missing $17 million, will you even try to look for that from Pilgrim's accounts?
Well, we will try. But let me further explain, Your Honor. Because when we filed the petition for freeze order against all those identified accounts, as far as the $81 million US dollars is concerned, and based on the initial evidence that we have gathered, it would appear that everything has been dispersed by Pilgrim. Some parts went to Blueberry, some parts went to Eastern Hawaii, which eventually went to Mr. Kim Wong, and some parts were allegedly delivered in cash to that Mr. Wei Kan Soo. So the $81 million has been accounted for, as far as our initial investigation.
Yes, if we are to believe Pilgrim's testimony, you know, first two, okay, and, there must be documentary evidence. That's why when Ms. Rubos Bautista was testifying on the cash deliveries, she was required to bring receipts, which she promised to bring, even the identity or identification document of that person who received, like a passport, which she promised to bring, which she did not bring. Okay, so medyo sablay na po yun, you know? And then there comes testimony from Mr. Kim Wong that there's a missing $17 million. So it's word versus word, but if you can believe the word of Pilgrim, can you not also believe the word of Kim Wong and take